Now I'd like to introduce former State Representative Keith Downey and the new Republican State Party Chairman, Keith Downey. Thank you.
Hello, good morning, everybody. It's a great day to be an American, isn't it? All right, good deal. Glad to have the global warming back, too, I think, right? So, hey, I just heard a really, really, really long list of the tax increases that have been proposed on Minnesotans, but I want to ask one of the state senators or state reps. I somehow missed the tax on double-blind trusts that are stored out of state. I don't see that one on the list. Hey, you know what? I had the chance to watch the State House on TV for a couple of hours. A little bit of an addiction when you're from the House. You like to watch this stuff. On Wednesday, when they were debating the tax bill, and I tell you what, I could not have been more proud of our guys. Really. Because you know what? The taxes are one thing, and they're a big thing. But frankly, they're just a symptom, right? They're a symptom of what we just heard from Senator Thompson and Representative Franson. All the things that they represent in terms of a different ideology and an approach to life here in America. And I watched Minority Leader Dowd's team, and they hammered on every single one of those tax provisions literally for 5 hours. To the point where the author of the bill was compelled to spend 40 minutes trying to rebut every single one of those points. But you know what the totality of it was? They were defending something more fundamental. And you know what it is? The line. The line that our founders set in just the right place between liberty and order, between what's private and public, between what's at the federal, state, and local levels, between what we bequeath to government and what we bequeath to the people. 5 hours of debate defending your ability to hold on to what we've always had as Americans. It was great. And you know what? I think back, Abraham Lincoln's picture is up at the front of the House chamber. And I thought back, you know what? Abraham Lincoln had it right. We are conceived in liberty as a nation, right? And that's always been risky. It always has been risky. It's cost us a lot. But we the people can do it. And you know what? It's not because we're perfect. And it's not because the individual is everything. It's not because somehow capitalism is our salvation. But you know what? It's because people created in the image of God were created to be free. Warts and all, risk and all. And that's what our guys were defending for 5 hours on the House floor the other day. And you know the other thing they were doing for us? And I had the chance to travel around the state for 3 months campaigning for this chair job. You know what? They were standing up for the people of Minnesota. I'm convinced that the Republican Party is now the party of the little guy. We really are. I'm telling you, we're standing with the people of Minnesota. And you know what? When we're free and a limited government fulfills its proper role, we can shine. And you know what? We can do a better job taking care of the poor and the downtrodden than any big government program. We have to believe that. So it's time for us to go on offense. And it started on Wednesday in the House chamber, and it's going to continue on Monday in the Senate chamber when they debate that tax bill. It's time to go on for us to go on offense for the people of Minnesota. The Democrats have branded themselves as the party that cares, right? We're here today to tell you that the person that cares the most isn't the one who writes the biggest check to state government. It's the people that do the hard work to fix what's broken. That's who really cares. The Democrats have told us that they stand with the poor. But we're here to say today that as Republicans and lovers of liberty, that it's not enough to stand with the poor in their poverty. We will never accept that. We will join arms with the poor and we will walk with them out of their poverty. And when the Democrats claim that they're the party of the middle class, all the while their economic and monetary policies are crushing the average person's chance in this economy and literally starving their kids of their American dream, we're going to stand up and tell them that we're going to fight for the economic liberty that provides people the dignity of a job and providing for their family and avoids that bleak dependency of an everlasting cycle of food stamps and welfare. That is what we are offering. That is what we started to go on offense for on Wednesday in the House, and that's what we're going to continue to go on offense for. You know what, folks? We are the GOP, the Growth and Opportunity Party. And you know what? That opportunity is for everybody. And the Democrats have tricked us into becoming a caste society where we talk about the poor and the middle class. You know what? We are the party of opportunity, liberty and justice for all, opportunity for all. That is what we will bring to the American people, the people of Minnesota, and that's how we'll win in 2014. Friends, I'm telling you, it's time for us to stand up and go on offense. It's time to shut down the class warfare. It's time to reclaim that Minnesota ethic that we all were raised with. It's time to believe in our people again. It's time to believe in the people of Minnesota again and not the programs that they build back here behind us. Let's shake off those shackles of government dependency. And let's proclaim that our kids, our Minnesota kids, can dream big American dreams again. And that's why I'm really honored today to have the chance to introduce somebody who frankly really needs no introduction. She's been a hero to the taxpayer forever, fought for the taxpayer's Bill of Rights. She's a tax lawyer, federal tax lawyer, started her own business. We all know who she is, and we all know that the Democrats are obsessed with her. Nancy Pelosi and the largest liberal PAC have already targeted her defeat in 2014. And you know what? If you thought what they did to Norm Coleman, if you thought what they did to the Minnesota legislature in the last couple of election cycles or something, well, just wait until you see what they unload on Michelle Bachmann in 2014, and it's already started. She's consistently fought for what is right, and the liberals hit her. They're playing as dirty a political game as you can possibly get, and it's no mystery that their candidate against her came up the same week that the false claims against her in Washington, D.C. came up. So you know what? We're going to stand by Michelle Bachmann. So let's please welcome our hometown hero, Michelle Bachmann.